हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट डेडलॉक. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विथ डेडलॉक, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सिस्टम मॉडल फॉर डेडलॉक. सो लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस सेशन आर, एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब सिस्टम मॉडल रिक्वायर्ड फॉर डेडलॉक. नाउ व्हाट इज डेडलॉक? एज वी नो, we have a multi-programming environment. So in multi-programming environment, multiple processes execute simultaneously in the system. And to execute that process, the resources are allocated. Now resources can be anything. It can be hardware resource or software resource. It can be memory, it can be CPU, it can be registers. Okay. So different resources are allocated to the process. So whenever process requires a resource, then that process must request for that resource. If that resource is available, then that resource is allocated to the process. This is done by operating system. But if resource is not available, then what will happen? Process will enter into the waiting state because that resource is not available and process cannot continue its execution. So the process enters in waiting state and that process may never again change its state and it remains in waiting state for a long period of time. So resources requested by the process may be held by some another waiting process. So here one process may request a resource which is already held by other process and that process itself is in waiting state. And due to this situation, all processes may enter into the waiting state and this situation is called a deadlock. Because no process is executing their task, the processes are in waiting state and no one can perform the task properly and that situation is called as a deadlock. They waste CPU cycles. Okay. So first we will see the system model required for deadlock. As we know, for system we have a finite number of resources, means number of resources are not infinite. We always have finite number of resources. So if your resources are same, then there are different instances of that resources. For example, resource means what? As I already explained, resource means it can be a memory space, it can be a CPU cycles, files, registers, IO devices, whatever it is. So if we have two CPU, then we can say that resource is CPU and we have two instances for that CPU resource. Similarly, if we have five printer, then it implies that we have a resource printer. But as we have five printers, there are five instances of that resource printer. So process must request an instance of resource type. Means if we have multiple instances of the resource, then the process must request an instance of a resource type. And if that instance of resource type is available, then it is allocated to the process. But if this is not possible, means if it is not possible to allocate the resource or allocate the instance to that process, that means that instances are not identical and we cannot allocate that instance to the process. So as I already told, before using any resource, process must request a resource. Once process requests a resource, if that resource is available, then it is given to the process. Process uses that resource and then after using that resource, process must release that resource. Why to release? Because if another process is waiting for that resource, if this currently executing process finish its use of that resource, then it can release it so that other process can use that resource. So process must release a resource after using it. So the number of resources requested may not exceed the total number of resources available. This means the processes never request a resource which are greater than available resources. That means if we have only two printers, then system cannot request or the process cannot request for three printers. Okay, so available are only two, then how it can request for three? Then error message should be generated. So process utilize a resource in following sequence. How it utilizes a resource? First, it requests a resource, then it uses that resource, then it releases that resource. Okay. Now, just pause the video and give answer. What will happen if process requests a resource which is already held by some another process? Okay. If the resource is already held by other process, then the process will enter into the waiting state. Okay. Now, as I am saying that process must request a resource, then use it and then release it. So to request and release a resource, processes must use system call. Okay. Now system call is nothing but predefined functions in operating system which are used by the processes whenever they need it. So we can say that we have a system call for a device that is request and release. Means whenever process wish to access a device, then there are a system call which are request and release. For files, we are using open and close. In our programming, we use open and close system calls for the file. Similarly, for memory, we use alloc and free. Okay, these system calls are already defined in the system. Then for semaphore, we have wait and signal system calls. And how these system calls are maintained? Actually, these system calls are already present there as a library, system library in operating system. And whenever process requests for a resource, at that time, these system calls are called. We already know the example of file. Open and close system call, which we use in our programming language. Now, what is the role of system table? System table here maintains the record that which resource is allocated to which process and which resource is free by which process. So here system call maintains all the record of the allocation and deallocation of the resources. Now, we can say that process is in deadlock state. When we will say process is in deadlock state? When process never changes its state. That state is waiting state. Okay. Now, we have different types of resources in the system. And that resources are physical resources and logical resources. So, how deadlock will occur in the system when we have same resource type? That we will see. Now consider a situation that we have three tape drives and we have three printer processes. So here three tape drive means what? We have only one resource, that is tape drive, and there are three instances of this tape drive. Okay, so that's why it is called as a same resource type. So we have a resource type tape drive and we have three instances of that resource type. Now we have three processes. So consider a situation that process P1 is already using tape drive 1, P2 is already using tape drive 2, P3 is already using tape drive 3. So all three processes are allocated to all three instances of the resources. Now suppose process P1 make request for tape drive 2, P2 make request for tape drive 3. And P3 make request for tape drive 1. Now, as you can see here, P1 is requesting tape drive 2, which is already held by P2. P2 is requesting tape drive 3, which is already held by P3. And P3 is requesting tape drive 1, which is already held by P1. So, what will happen? All these processes will enter in waiting state. And once they enter into waiting state, they will never release their resources, which is held by them. Okay, so these processes enter into the waiting state and they will never change their waiting state. So this situation is called as a deadlock state. And we can say that all processes P1, P2, P3 are in waiting state. Okay, next. Now we studied the example of same resource type. Now we are saying whenever we have a different resource type, how deadlock will occur in the system. So for different resource type, consider a system model which have two resources. Now we are saying we have two resources, that is tape drive and printer, and we have two processes. So suppose here process P1 is already using tape drive and P2 is already using printer. So P1 now request for printer, which is already used by P2, and P2 request for tape drive, which is already used by P1. Now again the same thing, P1 request this resource, but as this resource is already held by P2, P1 will enter in waiting state. Similarly, P2 request for tape drive, and as it is held by P1, P2 enters in waiting state, and both P1 and P2 enter in waiting state, then they will never release tape drive 1 and printer, and these two processes never get their requested resource. So automatically system enters in deadlock state. So this is how deadlock occurs in the system whenever all processes in the system enters into the waiting state and they are waiting for each other, and all processes are in waiting state, so they never change their waiting state and system cannot perform any fruitful task, and that situation is called as a deadlock situation or deadlock state. And the processes which are in waiting state, we can say that processes are in deadlock state. Okay, so this is how the deadlock can occur in the system. So these are the references. Thank you.